After the landlady come up and harassed me just about an hour ago. Oh, by the way, it's January 14th, Tuesday. It's about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I just got off the phone with Alex Gonzalez. Now, I want you to listen to what he says to me in these emails or voicemails, because he just double talked the shit out of me. Said he wasn't aware of my YouTube page.
I'm trying to get your phone call. Just left Angela a message in reference to the stuff that you had told me about, and also I did view it on your page there.
So you heard him say, I viewed it on your page. That means my YouTube page. Anyway, we can continue with this. Let's.
And just trying to get this figured out. Eventually, you know, if we don't hear from her, we're going to end up having to move forward with some things. So if you'd like to give me a call back, feel free. And we'll hear from you soon. Thanks.
And that was 12/10. So that was December 10th. Oh, there's more. Let's try this one.
John Alex, Borough Pottstown. Just left Angela a voicemail about
that was 12:30
seconds ago regarding the gentleman's ceiling who had caved in, also some other issues at the property. I have been getting your voicemails. We've been keeping kind of tabs on things, and I've tried to just get in touch with Angela multiple times, and I understand the issues, so if you want to speak to me, you can give me a call back at 610-970-6567. The only reason that this has gone to me as opposed to Charlie is because this is in my area and I've dealt with Angela's property before. So Charlie didn't necessarily pass the buck, but I have more on the property than Charlie did. So I kind of assumed the role of, who's gonna take everything over here. So if you want to give me a call again, 610-970-6567.
So he just got done telling me that there's not much they can do and until they reach court. I can bring my YouTube page to court, and it's all backpedaling, and I'm getting ready to go to a supervisor because this is insane. They're allowing this woman over and over to harass me, to try to get rid of me, because they feel if they get rid of me, the whistleblower that's telling all these violations here, they can turn a blind eye to it. And that's what it seems like it's going on, because nothing's being done. He says in the voicemail that he's seen my YouTube page, but then on the phone just now, he denied it, never seen it. So, you know, what the fuck is going on here? Why does this woman have a license to rent? That's what I'd like to know.